Project Fôtô is a program for young Vietnamese American women and gender non-conforming individuals to learn about printmaking, photography, and video art. And at the end of it, they take all this knowledge and all this kind of art that they learned and create pieces for an exhibition. So I think if you look at the students' work, you can see a sort of intention in the way that they create their work to not only express things that are happening to themselves, but also how those things connect to a larger Vietnamese American community.
It drove me to think more about like the concepts behind my artwork and trying to have like a message. Because the first thing we did with Nguyên-Lê was like talking about your family and who you are as a person and trying to convey that in a picture, which is like sounds so weighty and difficult. But I think it was a good growing pain.
A lot of the guest speakers and guest artists who came to give us their like mentorship actually talked about how they never had a space like Project Fôtô ever, and that they had a lot of challenges just even pursuing what they wanted to pursue in art. And so I thought that was really eye-opening, because if those people didn't take the chance to write, draw, create film, then I would have never got the chance to like see their artwork and like understand more about myself. So I realized that, you know, if you want to learn more about yourself, a lot of people have to take the risk to tell their stories in different ways that will reach people.
I feel like Project Fôtô does a lot to be inclusive to all walks of life within the Vietnamese American community. I know that a lot of the mentors that are brought into Project Fôtô are Vietnamese queer women or queer women identifying folks themselves. So I think having that kind of mentorship that reflects my own identity is extremely empowering.
So in the beginning, we didn't know what Project Fôtô was gonna become. I think we imagined that it could be something that helps students kind of dabble into art, but I think that it has the potential to really create and nurture and cultivate Vietnamese American artists, and especially Vietnamese American women and gender non-conforming artists. And I think that's such a special space.
There's not a lot of spaces like this, and I think that if there is spaces, people don't feel safe enough to open it up to others to share and learn from it. And so I feel grateful to like be in this space with others to like learn with them.
Like Vietnamese women tend to be portrayed in a certain way in video and media, and then we need to have more females to kind of like reverse that and show their own perspective, rather than always having like men or outsiders try to portray our lives and our stories.
After the exhibition went up and we saw all of our friends and family and supporters come through, I think it was really a moment where I realized that, wow, this program in like three, four months, really accomplished a lot. In such little time, and I'm so proud.